let me share my screen and start by introducing myself. My name is Sushma Sharma, and I have an experience of over 11 years in the training industry. I've been working with Poenix Solutions since March 2021. I've conducted trainings for organizations like HCL, American Express, Microsoft, and Tetra Tech, to name a few. I hold a bachelor's in computer applications, and I am also a Microsoft Certified Office Specialist 2019 for Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. So let's start and move on with the session. So this is the course for Introduction to Microsoft PowerPoint 2019. We have a total of 8 modules that we would be covering between today and tomorrow, which means that we would be covering the first 4 modules today, and the last 4 modules is something that we would be covering tomorrow. In the first module, we have on how to create a PowerPoint presentation. So since this is the introductory level course, we start right from the basics on how to start Microsoft PowerPoint, what are the different views available, the normal view, and how to create a presentation, saving a document, importing a file, the status bar, and closing a presentation. And every module that I would be covering with you will have a practice exercise associated to it. The next that we would be doing is about the ribbon. What is it that the ribbon consists of, the tabs, the functionalities associated to it, the different groups, the commands, and the tell me tab that we have in PowerPoint. And again, the practice exercise associated to it. After that, we would also have the quick access toolbar. And I'll take you through how to add the common commands onto the quick access toolbar and how to adjust the placement for it in respect to the ribbon. The fourth module that we would be covering today would involve a detail of the file menu, the entire file menu. What are the different options available in the file menu about opening a new presentation using some of the templates available, the properties, adding your own name to Microsoft PowerPoint. So this is what we would be covering in the fourth module today. When we meet up tomorrow, we would begin with the fifth module about formatting a PowerPoint presentation, selecting the slide layout, adding text from a text file or a Word outline in case you have any, editing the text, formatting the text as Word art, creating bulleted and numbered list, and the ink equation is for those of us who use the touchscreen devices. And finally, on how to add slides to a presentation using the format painter, duplicating an existing slide, arranging the slides. So all this will be covered in the fifth module. The sixth module will comprise completely of working with different kind of images, pictures, clip arts, how to format them, how to add them, and how to use it to your advantage when it comes to a PowerPoint presentation, creating custom color using the eyedropper, cropping an image, grouping and ungrouping images, arranging images, adding shapes. So all this we would be covering. And again, with the digital ink also, in case we are using a touchscreen device. The seventh module tomorrow that we would be covering will be all about charts and tables, in case we need to insert certain charts into a PowerPoint presentation for pictorial representation of data. We could do that. How to insert table, enter data into table, and then create various kinds of charts from that, and how to format the charts. And finally, the last module for this course will be about finalizing a presentation in terms of checking the spellings, accessing various different views of the presentation, the presenter view, changing the view to grayscale, and organizing a presentation in sections, adding transitions to slides, adding speaker notes, running a slideshow, and printing a presentation. So all this is something that we would be covering. Okay. All right. So let's start without wasting any further time. So creating a PowerPoint presentation, we start right from the basics on how to start PowerPoint. So the first thing that we do is we go to the Start button. Click here and I go to my PowerPoint and I select this. Now when I come here, I have two options. The first is I can choose a blank presentation. The second is I could choose from the various themes or the templates which are available here. So I have all the templates available. I have themes, education, charts, diagrams, business, infographics. I can choose any of the templates from here, and each template will further give me various designs that I can choose from. So for now, what I'm going to do here is I will select the blank presentation. Now, when I open the blank presentation, the default name that I always get will be presentation one until I save my presentation. Once I save my presentation, and how do I save it? I go to the file menu and I click on save as. Now, I also have the save command. What is the difference between save as and save as is? When I'm saving my presentation for the first time, wherein I will be required to give a name to the presentation, I will always choose save as. When I choose save as, it will ask me where do I want to save. Let's say I select the desktop and I say practice presentation and I click on save. So now presentation one has been named to practice presentation one. Now let me add a title to it. My first presentation. Now if I want to save whatever I have entered, I do not have to go back to the save as option, because if I do that, it will create another copy now. I only want this specific copy to be saved. I do not want everything that I do, every time I do something, I do not want different copies to be created. I want everything to be saved in this specific presentation that I've created. So therefore, I go to File and I click on Save. Let me close this from here. I go here. This is my practice presentation one. If I click on this, my data has been saved. So this is how, I'm sure you are aware of this, the difference between the save and the save as. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So this is how starting a Microsoft PowerPoint presentation. See, you could either choose from a blank or any of the templates available. Now when we open it, by default opens up in the normal view. This view that we have here is by default the normal view. I can check the view here as well. This is my status bar. This is my status bar. Let me add another slide here. So now what my status bar does is, my status bar shows me a lot of things. First, it shows me what is the total number of slides and what is my current slide, means what slide am I currently on. So it says slide 2 of 2, which means I am on the second slide and there are total number of 2 slides. If I select this slide, it tells me that I'm on slide 1 of 2, which means my current selection is slide number 1. However, there are total of 2 slides. The language that has been selected is India. We will come to the accessibility feature when we do the file menu in detail. If I click here on the notes and I pull up this section, this is for my speaker notes. My speaker notes. This one is for my speaker notes here. If I want, I can pull this down. I can pull this down from here. If I want, I can pull this up here. So this is my speaker notes area. In case I want to add any comments to the presentation, I can put that from here. And I can, it says there are no comments, be the first one, I can add in a comment from here. My first comment. I close this. Now this part gives me the different views that are available. This one is the normal view, the view that allows me to be able to create a presentation. This one is the slide sorter view. When I click on slide sorter view, I have thumbnails of all the slides that I've created. So if I have multiple slides, even if I have 100 slides, all of them will be available here, one next to the other. Each slide will be numbered. This is slide number one. This is slide number two. This one is the reading view, which opens up my presentation in a larger pane so that I can easily read it. I press the escape key and I come back to my slide sorter view, or I can go back to my normal view. This is my zoom bar. I can zoom in or zoom out. So I can increase or decrease the zoom. I can zoom in or zoom out. One thing that I'd like you to notice here is the comments that we had added shows up right here. See, it says click to show the comments pane. My comment shows up right here, my first comment. Have you ever added comments to your presentations?
No, I have more so when you're, I guess that's my question. When I'm giving or when I'm presenting, is it better to use the speaker notes or the comments?
It's better to use the speaker notes always speaker notes. Because when you're presenting, so, you know, let's say you are presenting from your own laptop and, you know, you have a projector. So your where, you know, your laptop is connected to. In that case, once you go to the presenter mode, which I will show you in the further modules, the speaker notes will only be visible to you. It will not be visible on the projector.
Okay, that's what I thought. Okay. But the comments will be visible on the projector, correct?
The comments will also not be visible to the projector. But, you know, see, if I do this, you see, the comments is also are also not visible. However, it's always a good idea. So, you know, when I'm on the presentation mode, the comments will also not be visible. But my personal suggestion always is, you know, comments are primarily added when you're trying to share your presentation with, you know, your colleagues, if you're working on a similar presentation or not the similar, on the same presentation. And, you know, you want your colleagues to take a look at a few comments that you've added that, you know, okay, this is what I've done. Take a look at this one. What do you feel about it? That is where you can probably add comments. But for your own, you know, reference when you're presenting, it is always a good idea to refer to your speaker notes, because when you use your speaker notes in the presenter view, you will have three things which appear on your screen. Your screen means on your laptop. First one will be the current slide. The second one will be the presenter notes. And the third one will be the next slide that will come up. So you are mentally prepared what slide is coming up next. However, the audience will only be able to view the current slide that you're presenting. They will not be able to see the speaker notes. They will not be able to see what slide is coming up next.
Okay.
So it just helps us to, you know, to be better prepared while we are presenting.
Okay.
Okay. Any questions so far?
No.
Now what we can do is we can import a file. We can import files. What we can do is we can either import text files into PowerPoint. Or we could, so let's just first start by importing text files. Let me see, where do I have text files? So let's say this is where I am. I can go to the file menu and I go to the open command. When I'm at the open command, it asks me whether I'd like to open an existing PowerPoint presentation or is there something else that I'd like to open? So I go to browse. Now I have a text file which I've saved on my desktop. So I will go there. And here the reason I'm not able to see any text file is because it only is letting me view the PowerPoint presentations. So I click here and I say all files. When I say all files, it lets me select. So see, do you want to open a read-only copy? Is it in use? Okay, this one is in use. Let me close this. And now it will allow me to open. So I say open, browse. All files have been selected here. And I say Visio 2016. So you see all the contents have been inserted here. However, everything is coming on a different slide. But it will definitely allow me to, because all these were different pointers in my text document. So what I could probably do is, let me close this one. Let me choose this one. And I now say open, browse, top, all files. Now it's still taking everything onto different slides only, but it will still allow me to enter what I want to. It will still allow me to import files in case, you know, I have, let me see if I have a Word document. Just one quick minute here. I'll just see if there is a Word document. Okay, let's just take a look at this one. I say file, open, there was something wrong with that file. It's not letting me import. However, if you go to file, do you have a Word document on your laptop or on your system?
I do. So I just, okay. Hold on, let me see.
So we've covered the status bar as well. And finally, about closing the presentation. Usually, when once we've saved whatever we want to do, we either close it from here or I can go to the file option, file menu, and I can say close. However, if I close from here, it will only close the current presentation that I'm at. It will not close PowerPoint on its own if I click the close. To close the PowerPoint, the application as such, which is running, I will have to still click on this cross that appears at the right side.